गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टीचिंग चैप्टर टू एंड नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर टू इज द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स फ्रेंड्स एंड फो. आई एम टीचिंग चैप्टर टू माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स फ्रेंड्स एंड फो. फ्रेंड्स एंड फो. फ्रेंड्स एंड फो. So yesterday I told you about the how we will make the curd and which bacteria is responsible for making the curd. And now I will tell you, yesterday we discussed about the useful microorganism, and in this term I told you about the how to make curd, and now I will discuss about the increasing soil fertility. Increasing soil fertility. Increasing soil fertility. Increasing soil fertility. How to increase the soil fertility and which microorganisms is responsible for that. So in this topic, you know that all plants and animals need nitrogen, and nitrogen present in the environment, you can just say that 78%, and some bacteria and blue green algae are the only organism that can take nitrogen from the air, and these microbes called the biological nitrogen fixers convert the elemental nitrogen to compounds of nitrogen which can be absorbed by the plant roots from the soil. And in this manner, soil is enriched with nitrogen compounds and its fertility is increased. So you know that nitrogen is present in the environment 78%, and how it is convert into the nitric form. So in this topic, I will tell you what is the nitrogen fixation. What is the nitrogen fixation? The process of converting atmospheric nitrogen into compounds of nitrogen is called the nitrogen fixation. What is the nitrogen fixation? The process of converting atmospheric nitrogen into compounds of nitrogen is called the nitrogen fixation, and this is brought about as mentioned by the bacteria and the blue green algae. It is done by the bacteria and is the blue green algae. So I think all of you understood what is nitrogen fixation. And you know that the roots of leguminous plant pulses, leguminous plants, they're like pulses. In example, you can take beans and peas. These roots bear certain solid structure that is called the root nodules, and the bacterium, name of the bacterium is the rhizobium, lives in the root nodules. Which bacteria? Rhizobium lives in the root nodules. Rhizobium, it lives in the root nodules, and this rhizobium lives in the root nodules. And this relationship between the roots of the plants such as peas and beans and the bacteria is symbiotic one. What is the symbiotic relationship? What is the parasitic? This one I will I think last class in last class you studied in chapter 1. So now next one is the production of alcohol, wine and vinegar. So in this also bacteria is used. Production of alcohol, wine, vinegar. Production of alcohol, wine and vinegar. So yeast is used for the large scale production of alcohol, wine and beer. So yeast is used in the production of beer, alcohol and wine, and for this purpose yeast is grown on natural sugars present in fruit juices and grains like barley, wheat and rice. Yeast brings about conversion of sugars into alcohol and carbon dioxide. And the process of conversion of sugar into the alcohol, that is called the fermentation. What is the fermentation? The process of conversion of sugar into the alcohol, that process is called the fermentation. And if a weak sugar solution, if you will take the example, if a weak sugar solution is exposed to the air in several days, a frothy scum appears on the surface, and when the liquid begins to smell of alcohol, and this changes takes place because tiny yeast cells have settled from the air into the liquid and have grown. And man has used this observation to make alcoholic beverages. And then aerobic bacteria, that is the acetobacter, are used for the production of vinegar, that is the acetic acid, from the alcohol. And the fungus, that is the aspergillus fungus, name aspergillus, is used for producing large quantities of citric acid, and that citric acid is used in the soft drink industry. And then now I am talking about the useful microorganism, means which microorganism is used and which microorganism is useful. So production of antibiotics, while we are making antibiotics, in this also microorganisms are used. So you can see that antibiotics are the chemicals that kill or stop the growth of certain kinds of microbe. What is the use of the antibiotics for stopping or for killing? We used any kind of diseases, that antibiotics kill that microbes which is present in the body. Antibiotics are the chemicals that kill or stop the growth of microorganism or microbes, and they help our body to fight diseases. That's why if you are suffering from any kind of diseases, then doctors prescribe the antibiotics because it helps in the fight against diseases. So you can see that the meaning antibiotics. What is the meaning of antibiotics? I will tell you. Antibiotics. So you can see that antibiotics, it comes from the two Greek words. I will write, then you can see. Antibiotics, name I think you heard, antibiotics. So antibiotics come from two Greek words meaning against life. Antibiotics, against life. Antibiotics meaning against life. And antibiotics work only against certain forms of life. This antibiotics works against the certain form of life. So you can see that this, now all of you understood what is antibiotics. Antibiotics is a kind of chemical which is used for kill or stop the microbes. So what is the meaning of antibiotics? Against life. And you can see that the development of antibiotics began with the discovery of penicillin by Sir Alexander Fleming in 1928. Fleming noticed that an agar plate incubated with bacterium Staphylococcus aureus had become contaminated with a mold. And he further noticed the presence of a clear zone in the agar plate which breakdown of the bacterial cells had occurred, and detailed study led to the isolation of an inhibitory substances formed from the molds, as the mold was identified as penicillium. Fleming called the antibiotic as penicillin. Fleming called the antibiotic as a penicillin. And soon after antibiotics, just after the antibiotics isolated from either bacteria or the fungi, and streptomycin, erythromycin, tetracycline are some of the commonly known antibiotics. What is the name of that antibiotics? Streptomycin, erythromycin, tetracycline are some of the commonly known antibiotics which are made from the fungi and bacteria. These antibiotics made from the fungi and bacteria, and antibiotics are used to cure a variety of diseases in humans, plants and animals. Antibiotics are used. So what is the precautions while we are taking antibiotics? Precautions should be there. So should be taken only on the advice of a qualified doctor. We can't take according on their own. How much dose prescribed by the doctor, that much dose we will take, and must complete the entire course as prescribed by the doctor, and excess dose must not be taken because excess dose is harmful. So I think all of you understood till here, and tomorrow we will discuss about the vaccine. What is the vaccine? So till here you will take a revision.